Hello children. So children, in the last video I have put two questions for you. So did you try to find it out? Okay, now let's see what will be the answer. First one, you see, differentiate between decantation and filtration. And what is the answer? The answer is in decantation the mixture is left undisturbed for some time and then the liquid is poured into another vessel without disturbing the sediments. And what is filtration? Filtration, the mixture is not left undisturbed like in decantation, okay, undisturbed for sediments to settle down. The mixture is poured in a vessel through a filter paper. So in decantation we don't use filter paper and here we use filter paper. Got it? And now second question, give an example of filtration at home. So what are the filtration we use at home? Answer, we will see. Examples of filtration at home is strainer. Okay, we use strainer for what? We use strainer for separating tea leaves from tea. So we were discussing about the separations of materials. Here again today we will continue with the separations. Now we will see what is evaporation. The process in which a liquid changes into gaseous state is called evaporation. So children, now what is evaporation? The process in which the liquid is changes into gaseous or gaseous state is called evaporation. Evaporation is used to separate a soluble solid present in a solution. So evaporation is used where it is used to separate the soluble solid, okay, soluble solid present in a solution. In this method, the mixture whose components are to be separated is heated. So here in this method, what do? We heat the mixture. Like whose components are to be separated, these are heated. And what happened after heating? Upon heating, the liquid part of the mixture gets evaporated, leaving behind the solid part. So when this mixture are heated, what will happen? The liquid part in the mixture, the liquid parts of the mixture will evaporate. It forms into gases and it evaporates and it leaves the solids behind. Sea water contains a large amount of salt dissolved in it. So as we all know that seawater contains a lot of salt in it. Evaporation is used to obtain salt from seawater. So you see the picture here, figure 5.7. This is the figure 5.7, separation of salt from seawater by evaporation. So let's see now how this salt are separated from the seawater. To obtain salt, seawater is collected in a shallow ponds called salt pan. So to obtain the salt, what happens? Seawater is collected in a salt pans, or we can say shallow ponds. Seawater collected in the salt pan is allowed to dry in the sun. So what happened? This collected seawater are dried in the sun. Sun's heat evaporates the water leaving behind the salt in the salt pan. So after heating, what happened? The sun heats evaporate the water, and it leaves the salt in the salt pan. Salt is collected from the salt pans and is sent for further purification. So the salt is now ready for collecting and it is collected from the salt pan and it is sent for further purification. Purified salt can be used for various purposes. So these salts are now used for various purposes. So you see there here, this is how the evaporation is done. Separation of salt and the sea water. Now let's see condensation. The process in which a gas changes into a liquid state is called condensation. Condensation is the opposite of evaporation process. Condensation takes place only when vapor comes in contact with a cold surface. So what is condensation? It is the process where a gas changes into a liquid state. Okay, and condensation is the process of, condensation is the opposite of evaporation process. In evaporation, as we have already learned that the liquid is changes into gaseous state, and in condensation the gas is changes into a liquid state. So here again you see condensation takes place only when vapor comes in contact with a cold surface. So what happens? Where do this condensation occur, or where do it takes place? It takes place when this vapor it come in contact with a cold surface. So you see the picture here, the vapor comes in contact with the glass and it forms into a liquid. Now we'll see use of more than one method of separation. Many a times it is not possible to separate the substances present in a mixture using a single method. In such cases, two or more methods are used for separations of substances present in a mixture. So what happened in some mixture, using one separation method is not possible. Using a single method is not possible. So in such case, what we will do is we will be using two or more methods in order to separate the substance present in the mixture. So children, now let's see what this table is about. Methods of separation. So what are the methods of separations? We have already discussed. Those are sedimentation, decantation, filtration, handpicking, tracing, winnowing, sieving, evaporation, and condensations. So what is sedimentation, decantation, and filtrations? Those are done in order to separate insoluble solids from liquids. Here you see separating insoluble solids from liquids. And handpicking is done for separating slightly larger impurities. And tracing, separating grains from stalks. Winnowing, separating grains from chaff. Sieving, separating smaller and bigger particles. Evaporations and condensation, separating soluble solids from liquids. So these are the things that we have learned in the separations of materials. So again, let's see here the summary of this chapter. First one, you see pure substances are made up of only one types of particles. As we have learned what pure substance is, it is a substance made up only of one types of particles. Here second, we will see substance can be separated by handpicking, sieving, winnowing, tracing, sedimentation, decantation, filtration, evaporation, and condensation. And last one, we will see many times two or more methods are used to separate substance present in a mixture. So here we stop with our this chapter 5, that is separations of materials. So let's stop here today. We'll meet in the next video with our new chapter.